Hey, what's up, guys? It's me, Hoovy11, aka Niba Hiba, and welcome to a new video. Yeah, today I'm gonna make something new. And yeah, I wanna say that because I wanna make my channel into a new direction, something that has been not taken before. Like, I've used to post a lot of random shit before. Like, shit didn't have sense at all. And yeah, I'm still gonna post that kind of stuff, but for a while, I've decided to do some really interesting series. Like, you could have seen my past reviews, thanks to my own comic series, talking about reviews and shit, facts, my personal opinions, but today I'm gonna do something new. You may know that I've said in my previous video, I'm pretty sure if you didn't see it, then you know now, I said that Suleiman is my favorite band. And I thought that today I could make top tier Suleiman songs list, because why not? And I'm pretty sure you guys are kind of curious about my opinion. So yeah, again, I wanna say that Suleiman is my favorite band. I absolutely love Iowa, self-titled. We Are Natural Kind, basically each album, but mostly Iowa, and self-titled. But I also really love We Are Natural Kind, and I'll hope he's gonna popular opinion. About Subliminal versus The Great Chapter, I found both of the albums to be really, really great, but not as good as the superior ones. And yeah, I know what you're saying. I hope he's gone is better than Subliminal versus or The Great Chapter. Well, Mr. I don't know what the fuck is your name, that's my opinion. But anyways, let's start the review. I'm telling you from now, we ain't gonna vote and have a listen, because I said it, I'm a hardcore Slipknot fan, and I've listened to basically each song. And some of them maybe have been kind of forgettable, but we're gonna see about this. But there's an issue before I saw this. I hope there won't be any filler in here. Like, if I am gonna fill all those, I hope there'll be more space. And please tell me in the comments which tier list should I make next. Should I make a best Korn songs tier list, or best Slipknot masks or something? But please tell me in the comments. And if I don't, for example, if you tell me a band and I don't like or something, then I just simply ignore it. But you could recommend me a lot of alternative new metal bands and some groove and trash. No, not a problem. That old school trash like Megadeth, Metallica, or groove like Pantera and shit. I don't care. Just tell me in the comments. But okay, let's stop wasting time. So let's begin. First song, AOV from The Great Chapter. From what I remember, this song was really nice. It had a really blasting sound to it. It was really heavy in the most part, really catchy, but I swear it gave me some headaches of how fast and trash it was in its verses. However, I really liked the melodic breakdown in the chorus, but not really one of my favorites. But because it's still a really great song, and it's definitely one of the best in Great Chapter, even if, to be honest, The Great Chapter is my least favorite album. Somewhere in B and C, but I think I'm gonna give it a C, because I don't really see myself going back to it all the time. Next is Be Prepared for Hell, which I honestly kind of find a forgettable song. I really don't remember that much about it. I really don't. I think I remember that it was some sort of intro to The Negative One, but I really didn't like it, but it's kind of a good intro for an intro, because I guess that's what the purpose was for it. But hey, half for it. I really didn't like it, it wasn't that special. Q-Ster! Holy shit, I love that song, definitely going on B. Fucking awesome song, it's really angry, really good, catchy, like the chorus is cut, coming up. It's really heavy overall, it's really great, I love the blasting when I'm angry. I'm not a big fan of this song, but because it was made for Paul Gray, I think I'm gonna put it to C. Again, not a really big fan of it. I don't really see myself going back to it, but I really love Paul Gray. This idea, he was a really great musician, and he's really missing it to this day. If Rain Is What You Want. I really didn't like that song. I really found it forgettable. Sorry. Kill Pop, definitely going. That makes that draining. Hey, really great song. Almost going to S, but I think there will be more songs over here from Iowa and self-titled. So yeah, I'm gonna leave it here for a while. But if there will be any space, I'm gonna put it at S here. Leech, you know, didn't really like that song, but it was pretty great, so I'm gonna give it a D. Nomadic. Holy shit, Nomadic. That song was good, but I really didn't like it that much. It's pretty much on the same level with Leech. I really liked the solo, and the intro was great, but I really don't remember that much of it. Override, didn't listen to it, or I did just once, so I don't really remember that much about it. Sarcastrophe going to fucking A, I don't care. Sceptic was that song with I've never, the world never see another motherfucker like you or something. That song was great, but it was good, it was great, I really liked it. The Burden, same as Override, just listened to it once. The Devil and I is pretty overrated in my opinion, but I really like the silence it stops between it and all that shit. So yeah. The Negative One going definitely on S, one of the best Slipknot songs that I've heard. Or actually, we'll see. If we have space here, I'm gonna put it with Kill Pop. You know, I'm just trying to find a fillers in here. What is this? The One That Kills Always. I don't remember that song going on F. I've listened to it a lot of times, but I didn't really like it. 19, or I guess. I don't really know that much. But 19 was a great opener, a great intro to the great chapter. I really like the singing it, the singing style. So I think I'm gonna put it to C. That's an intro, we're gonna put it as an intro, we're gonna put it to, even if it's the intro to Sick, one of my favorite Slipknot songs, I really don't find it memorable. Deluded is kind of underrated, I really like that song. Eeyore, well, there's something really good about this song, but, I think I'm gonna prefer, but Eyeless going in S, no, we don't even talk about this. Get This is a really great song, really, really handbanging stuff. I really love this song every time it's going to my playlist. Liberate, good-ass song. Really great, actually, so I'm gonna put it on B. Me Inside, I really like the chorus for that one. Wait, what the fuck? So we don't have... Now I understand. Now I understand. Okay, put it back. Oh, shit, what the fuck have I done? Well, never mind. No Life is going on pretty much kind of, it was a great song, but not really one of my favorites, so yeah. Prosthetics, really great ass song. I've dedicated this I've dedicated this song to my wife. She loved it, and this is one of the songs that got me introduced with her, so I would always thank her. So I'm gonna put it on A. Only one, why is it at C? It should be at D. I don't know what the fuck did I do, but Purity going S. I don't care. Purity, really fucking good song, really great. Skizzers, I listen to this song every time I'm pissed. I really like the dark influence, like it's so psychotic and crazy, but I listen to the song in a different way compared to the others. Same with Iowa. But because when every time I'm pissed to it and it really helps, I'm gonna put it on A. Sick, definitely going on S. Spit It Out, really great ass song. The rapping, what the fuck have I done? Oh, go. The rapping on it is really great, really fucking energetic, and around the jump the fuck up part is all fucking awesome. Surfacing, one of my favorite Slipknot songs. Fuck It All, fuck, these were the classic. Tattered and Torn, kind of underrated this song in my opinion, but not one of my favorites. Wait and Bleed, great ass song, but kind of overrated, so I'm gonna put it on B. I don't really like it. I find My Flag to be better, so yeah. Moving on, we are at my favorite, not only favorite Slipknot album, but my favorite goddamn album of all time, actually. There's something about Iowa that I can't explain. It's angry. It's heavy. It's dark. It's pure emotional. There's something about it I can't really explain. It's different to the first album, but it's pretty much the same levels of heaviness. There's so much emotion and pure anger to it. Hell, I could even say that it's a little bit more emotionally angrier than the first one. Not that kind of psychotic anger, like, you know. But I also love the melodic in it, and melodic and all that shit. Wait, I should have been talking about the rating of the songs, not the my opinion of my album. Sorry about this, but I just wanted to let you know why I think that Iowa was the best album. 550, I don't know what to say about this song. It's an intro after all, so all the intros are going to be, because it gives that, without it, the song punch will kind of be incomplete. Bottom people equal shit and sick, so, disaster piece D, see, Jesus Christ, we don't even talk about this, okay? Everything and C, fucking fantastic song, I love this one so much, it's so, and like, oh, you are wrong, fuck, I love it, I just, generally, I kind of find underrated, but not one of my favorites. I really love the screaming build-ups and all that shit. It's really, it's kind of heavy, but, you know, slow and hellish. So, yeah, I've met a lot of people that hate this song, and I don't understand why. Theoretic Anthem, we're not even talking about this. See, with your 555 and a fucking 666. I'm hated is kind of underrated. Even if I do consider that this song doesn't really fit on Iowa. Oh wait, no, it's better for B, honestly. Because it's maybe my least favorite song from this album, but not really. But hey, let's remember that Iowa was my favorite album. And I'm gonna leave this to B because it's not really that interesting and it doesn't really sound like the album. But it's a really great song. I've used the instrumental from it to Vlad. It's fucking Vlad. Jesus, I even forgot my song name, but oops, what did I do? God, what did I do? Skizzers was here and Theoretic Anthem was here and oh no. Oh, now I understand what I did. Technical difficulty! I have no fucking idea what was that, but moving on. Iowa, again, really psychotic song. Just I love this one actually more than Skizzers, but can we rate it higher? Left Behind, a really great song, melodic, heavy, at the same time. The outro's fantastic, the bridge is good as fuck. Really great song, really, really great. Metabolic is fucking heavy, but, fucking mouse. I can't really rate it higher than B, because it's not really that, you know, it's not really that, how can I say it? It's not. Maybe how Slim would have made it to be like big, even if you can know that they're not playing it at all. It's not really unique, but it's really heavy. One of the heaviest songs on Iowa. My Plague is basically a rip-off to Wait and Bleed, but I like this song more than Wait and Bleed, which is pretty weird. So I'm gonna rate this one as an A. New Abortion, honestly, my least favorite song on Iowa, and maybe the only song that I'm gonna rate it on C. Not really great, in my opinion. Meh. Not really great. I wish they played the more The Shape or Skin Ticket instead of New Abortion. People Equal Shit, kind of a rated song in my opinion. Yeah, in my opinion. So it goes on A, and I don't care what you say. That kind of rhymed. Skin Ticket, love this song, but oops. I can't really rate it more than A because it's not really that special, but I really love the instrumental tribal sound to it, like, and it's pretty much like Genwe. It's that slow, hellish type of song, but it's really heavy at the same time. I really love that song. But yeah, and it's, you can see it's on the same level with Genwe. The Shape, more like my second favorite Slipknot song. The verses are fantastic. I love the bass and those, the chorus voice. The chorus is fantastic, like, Corey's voice combined with the melodic that he does, the melodic line, I lost my only way. It's so good, man. And it's so brutal at the same time. And The bridge, the rapping part, or how I want to call it, is fucking great. He has a flow that I've never really heard in a Slipknot song before. The final chorus is even more energetic, and the outro is just goosebumping. A really underrated song, in my opinion. But hey, moving on, All Hope Is Gone. All Hope Is Gone, the song, which I found it to be a pretty good song, actually. But I don't really like it more than most songs on All Hope Is Gone, so I'm gonna leave it on B. Bachisuk, we don't even talk about this. And now you're saying now, you hate it because most of the Slipknot fanbase said, no, I've listened to this song for a lot of fucking times enough. Oh shit. I skipped it for a lot of times, so we don't wanna talk about this. Sorry for the fucking ad, but I can do anything. I wish I'll die. Child of Burning Time, good song. Yeah, I think it's not actually on the official release of All of This Gun, but I really like this song. Burn me away, you know, it's really good. I really love this song. I'm not waking up to Dead Memories. It's the Child of Burning Time and Dead Memories kind of sound actually the same. So I'm gonna leave Dead Memories here. Execute good ass intro. Guys, I'm telling you, this is my favorite Slipknot song. And I'm not joking when I say this. I just love the song so much. I love the riffs, the silent, dark, and psychotic lyrics. I don't know, the chorus is so great, so melodic, but so heavy, like so. When I found this song in a really rough time. When I was working, for example, on the fifth comic. From this season, when pretty much everything in my life was almost falling apart, I found this song in the blind and I cried when I first listened to it. I really love this song, will always hold a really special place in my heart. And not only this, but it's my favorite song of all time. The solo is great, the vocals are great, the outro is great, the final chorus is just out of the world. And if you didn't listen to the song, I really recommend you to do it. If you want a really slow type of ballad, but really heavy at the same time, song, so give it a try if you didn't. Gematari, a really fucking awesome song. Really good, really groovish. I really like the how heavy it is and how poor his vocals deliver on that one. People may say that this one is overrated. I don't care. Psychosocial is the first song I've ever listened to them. I don't know, always love it for this. Psychosocial is a really good ass song. Snuff, an emotional song, or an emotional roller coaster, I want to call it. It's going on A. I really love this song, really love the touching lyrics. The final part is just so hitting. Sulfur, really fucking nice ass song, going on A definitely. This Callback is a really underrated song. It's going on B. That was pretty similar to Sulfur and Gematar at the same time. Really underrated, in my opinion. Till We Die, just a Brothership song, I can't say shit about it, and I listen to it when I'm down sometimes. Vendetta, don't really like that one, but it had some great parts. Wherein Lies Continue, I don't remember that much about this one, so I'm gonna leave it on the same level with Vendetta, but the thing is that I think this one is a little bit better than Vendetta. Vendetta, sorry! You get a point. Moving on, now we have two more albums. Now we are up to Sublime Versus. So the first song, before I forget, really overrated song, just a repeating a riff over and over, and kind of a nice chorus, doesn't really add to me a much. I really don't understand why Slipknot chooses in a single over 3-0, or even if it's not my favorites, Opium of the People. I see a lot of people love that song. But it's still pretty great, so I'm gonna leave it to D. Circle, underrated ass song, in my opinion. Even if I don't really see myself always going back to it. You're something that Slipknot has never done to it before, and I really understand the mind before it. Danger Keep Away will go on B, if it was the full version. But I think this one is referring to the shorter version, which actually is, as we've done, Sad Tone, when at the end of the album. So it's going on C. Don't Get Close. I really don't like that song. It was on the special edition, the Australian version of the Sublime Versus. So I think I'm gonna leave it on Let me think. It's not that bad, but I really don't like it, so, D. Duality, just like the psychosocial, people may say that it's overrated, but there's something about this, the silent vocals in the verse, the legendary opening vocal line, the chorus is something out of the world. And not that kind of cringy, that cringy type, like, I'm the war before I'm a man. It has a different sense in it, in the lyrics. And a bridge, in my opinion, is better. But the only thing that Before I Forget was better at than Duality was maybe actually the bridge. I regret about what I said previously. The Duality bridge isn't that great. Before I Forget was more melodic and it brings me a lot of more memories. So, Opium of the People, real underrated song, really great ass riff, really great ass chorus. Nincho, I don't even know if we should rate those anymore. But you know what? I really think the intros and those songs like Skeezers, IOR, Danger, Keep Away, the full version should have been a different rating, with all honesty. Pulse of the Maggots, really great ass fucking song, going on A. I really love the riff in that one, the vocals are cool. It's the chorus, we are the Pulse of the Maggots, it's so great, and the bridge is so heavy and so angry. Scream is an underrated song, really underrated. I'm honestly gonna give it a, let me think. It's better than those songs right here for me. I really love Scream. Really love it. The Blister Exists, that song is really great. No question, I'm gonna give it a C. It's literally legendary. The chorus is I am, and that drum solo, it's awesome. The Nameless is my favorite song on Soluna Verses. I just love how the verses are so crazy, like and the chorus is so melodic, it's so slow all suddenly. It's just really great. Love the song. The Virus of Life. This song is kind of similar to Purity, to Prosthetics, to how is it, Skin Sick and all that shit. So I'm gonna put it on A, and I really liked it. And yeah, it was all great. It's pretty much again a pretty psychotic message to the victim. Something can happen to my wife Andrea, but we're not talking about this. 3-0. It's almost as good as The Blister Exists, but I don't know. There's something and it doesn't really mean that make it that memorable as it. So we're gonna put it on A. But I really love that song too. Vermilion Part One. I like this song a lot. Don't get it wrong, but still kind of overrated in my opinion. Except for the last chorus and the hard-hitting outro. In my opinion, there's nothing really special about the song. The verses are kind of boring, but not a big deal. Vermilion Part Two, unlike the Part One, is way better, way more soul-touching, and yeah. Why do I sometimes have a British accent? I'm sorry for my accent changes, but yeah. And the last one, Welcome, which I really don't find really memorable songs. One of the least. Actually, I'm gonna leave it here because it's not really that great. I really don't really like it. Okay, guys, so now we've come to the final album, the latest Slipknot album, We Are Natural Kind. So we're gonna rate this one as well. A Liar's Funeral is one of my favorite songs on the album. I don't really care what you say, but We Are Natural Kind was a really solid album. A Liar's Funeral had a really, it had a ballad sound to it, but it was really angry at the same time. Something that Slipknot didn't make before. Something really unique, and Corey's vocals on that one, it's fucking awesome. The guitars, everything about it is so great. Bird of the Cruel, kind of overrated song in my opinion. Even if when I released the song, I really didn't like it that much, so it's going on C. Critical Darling, like Bird of the Cruel. I like that song on my Bird of the Cruel. I really like it, but I can rate it higher than those. Or maybe. Maybe. Yes, I'm gonna leave it here better, honestly. That because of that again is just an intro. God damn it, do we need to put intros in the same fucking level? Insert coin, god damn it. I hate how I really like that this album featured interludes, but because this album had a lot of interludes, insert coin and a really futuristic sound to it. I know this opinion is kind of weird because what I said at the beginning of the video was kind of strange, but insert coin was actually a pretty nice intro to take off the interludes, and I really love that Suema really experimented with interludes in this album. So My Pain, I really didn't like that song, honestly. It's bad. Even if Anderson and Slim experimented with it, cannot judge them. I really didn't like it, honestly. Narrow Forte going on ass. Dope versus dope chorus, dope riff, dope drum bits, everything about it. Not long for this word, didn't really remember a lot of it, honestly. Orphan going ass. Iowa mixed with Sumna versus at its finest. Awesome chorus, awesome versus, like, so heavy, so fucking awesome. Red Flag is pretty much reminiscent of the Negative One and Surfacing at the same time, so it's going here. Soulway Fierce is going on ass, really angry ass song. Really fucking good. Spiders, from what I know, is a kind of hated song from most Swimming fans that I know, but I really don't see what's the problem with it. I really like it, and I'm putting on A. Really like it, and I love the industrial sound of it. It reminds me of Nine Inch Nails and shit like that. Unsainted, really fucking awesome song. Unsainted is going to A, because I don't think it's better than those songs. Like, most of those just hold a special place in my heart. Unsainted is a really great song, and I'm glad it chose this as the lead single for the album. No, not gonna lie. What's next? Again, a fucking interlude, so I'm not gonna put this. I love Life compared to most songs from We Are Natural Kind was kind of different, but I really like that one too. But honestly, as heavy as it was, kind of it sounded kind of a rip-off to me. A rip-off to the Blister Exists, and honestly expected more. I'm glad they actually went better with this album. Honestly, I'm telling you the last fact, I didn't expect this album to be so great at all. I didn't expect We Are Natural Kind to be so fun. Well, guys, thank you for watching. Thank you so much, actually, for wasting your fucking time and seeing on my personal opinion. So here's the entire list, as you can see. Tell me what you think in the comments. Tell me if you disagree with me. Tell me if you think there's a song that you think is underrated, or you think that I'm stupid or retarded or something. And, guys, don't forget to watch my other videos, like reviews of my comic series and shit like that. And, what else can I say? Stay good. Have a nice day. And, don't forget to, you know, stay cool. By the way, this video was made for my wife, sponsored for my wife. I love you so much, Andrea. I swear I'm gonna leave the fucking... Actually, never mind. It's our secret. I'm so sorry.